Hello everyone. So today we are here to discuss the concept of encoder. So previously we have seen what is in the decoder, and now we will see what is encoder. So encoder is nothing but it is a circuit which will perform the entire opposite operation of decoder. So in decoder, what it is happening? It is taking n number of inputs and it is generating 2 power n number of outputs, right? It is nothing but your decoder. And now what I am saying is the reverse operation of decoder will be done with the encoder circuit. What is reverse operation? It will take 2 power n inputs. It will take 2 power n inputs and it will give your n number of outputs. That is your encoder. The reverse operation of decoder is encoder. Okay. The reverse operation of this will be your encoder. Okay, so see here, you are having 2 power n number of inputs and these will be reduced to n number of outputs, and the n number inputs will be same as in the previous condition. Here also, these are the special inputs which are only required for us in order to either on or off the circuit. Okay, either on and off the circuit. Okay, so when you clearly observe this, if in this particular diagram, 2 power n inputs are supplied, n outputs are generated, and n other inputs are there for either on and off of the circuit. So, see clearly, a digital circuit that performs the inverse operation. Okay, find the word called as inverse operation. That means it is purely performing the opposite operation of decoder is called as encoder. It will have 2 power n in number of input lines, and it will generate n output lines. Okay, n output lines. In encoder, the output lines generate binary code responding to the input value. Okay, these output lines, okay, will generate the binary code with respect to the input value. Okay, so see, the truth table operation will be entirely same. Just to reverse that, in the previous decoder, what are all the inputs present that will become under outputs, and what are all the outputs present there that will become as input here. Okay. So if you see clearly, see what I have done. I took an example of 8:3. Previously it is 3:8. I took it as 8:3. 8:3 is nothing but this, you can call it as an octal to binary. Why? Because they're having 8 inputs, right? So octal to binary decoder. It is very, very important. The reverse of the 3:8. The reverse of 3:8. So what I'm having here, you add one more column here, enable. Or else you can write manually like if enable equal to 1. Then the truth table is given as like that. You can write, or else you can add a column here for enable, put all ones like this. That's your wish. Either you can write a statement manually, or you can add that column into this. And remember that when enable is equal to 1 only, you will get these particular outputs. Okay. Now, see here. Previously, what we have seen, 8 combinations in input side, and all ones like this will be in output side. And now what it became here, for the first input, you will get first combination like 000. For second input as highlighted, you will get second combination. For third input, you will have third output combination. For fourth input, for fourth output combination like that. For each and every input combination where one is selected, you will have its own particular binary output. Its own particular binary output. What is this? D0. D0 is activated, means the zero binary form as 000. That will be get to your output. Okay, observe clearly. I am keeping 1. That means I am taking 1 for D0. D0 means here index value is 0. So zero binary format is 000. That will be taken at output. Come to second input. When second input is highlighted, that means D1. 1 is index value. 1 form of binary means 001. What is this one? D2. Here index value is 2. So 2 in terms of binary 010. That is taken at output. Like that, for each and every input, their own respective index values will be converted into the binary form. That is nothing but your encoder. So for each and every input highlighted, you will get its own binary format, its own binary format. Why I am saying own means, wherever you keep one, that particular input index value is converted into binary. That's it. Suppose if you take D4 as highlighted, that means this concept. D4 means 4 is index value. Convert 4 into binary form, 100. That will be get in your output. Okay. So how can you say the output of encoder means which bit is highlighted, that index value's respective binary format is get in output. Suppose if you take D3 as highlighted one, the 3 is index value, therefore the binary format of 3 is 011, and that will be obtained at your output. Okay. So this is the truth table of octal to binary encoder. So by using KMap, or you can directly write the equation for A, the equation for B, and the equation for C. So how will write for these? See, this A is the combination of these 4 ones. Okay, in the column of A, you are having these 4 ones. So this one is related to D4, plus this one is related to D5, plus this one is related to D6, plus, and this is related to D7. So the equation of A will become D4 plus D5 plus D6 plus D7. Okay. Nish, what about for B? These 2 ones and these 2 ones. Okay. So what you will get? D2 plus D3 plus D6 plus D7. Like that you will have. And for C, alternative ones are there. So you will get D1, so D1 plus D3 plus D5 plus D7. Let us see the diagram. See here, for A, what I mean, 4, 5, 6, 7 are adding. See, for A, this one related to D4, D5, D6, D7. So all these were added. Okay. I took 8 inputs like D0 to D7, 8 lines I kept. And adding plus no, so take one OR gate, supply D4, D5, D6, D7 to this, so that you will get A. And what about B? It is the combination of D2, D3, these two ones, D2, D3 and D6, D7. So take an OR gate, connect D2, D3, D6, D7, you will get this one. And what about C? Alternative 1, 3, 5, 7. So take an OR gate, 1, 3, 5, 7. Connect all this, then it will become as well octal to binary encoder diagram. And don't forget to write the statement here. Okay, right here, enable equal to 1. Either you write manually under enable equal to 1 condition, I am getting this diagram, like that you write, or you add one more line here. Sorry, you add one more line here and mention it like enable. Mention this like enable and join this for each and every gate. Join this for each and every gate. Or you can write manually like this. If, or else you can write under the condition of enable equal to 1, then I will get this diagram. Like that you can write manually, or you can add a column like this. That's your wish. Okay. Next, we will come across an important encoder called as priority encoder. So a priority encoder is an encoder that includes the priority function. Okay, this encoder will always depends, or it always works on the concept of priority function. What is this priority function? This priority function will decides which input is to be activated first. Okay, which input is to be activated and which input is given the highest priority. That is to be solved first. Okay, so depending on the priority function assigned by the user, this encoder will start its operation. Suppose if two or more inputs are equal to one, then the priority function exists. Okay, what this priority encoder, if two or more inputs are equal to one at the same time, then the input having highest priority will take the precedence. Okay, so when you see the truth table, let us take four inputs t0, d1, d2, d3. So, and v is your priority function. V is the priority function. And the y1, y0 are your outputs. Okay. Four inputs means how many outputs you will have? Only two outputs. Why? Because 4 into 2 is a decoder format, encoder format. 4 into 2 is a encoder format. So for four inputs, you will have two outputs. And this v is separate, which is a priority function. Suppose if v is equal to 0. Suppose if v is equal to 0, that means priority function is not assigned. Then you won't get any outputs. Why? Because it is a priority encoder which always depends on the priority function. If priority function is not assigned, then this encoder will not work. Okay. Suppose if 4 ones, that means v is assigned as 1. That means priority function is given. Like enable only, this priority function will be acting. If priority function is not given, that means it is 0, the circuit won't work. The circuit will work only when v is equal to 1. That means priority function is activated. Okay. So see here. So leave this case. It is an false case. See here. Suppose if d0 is activated. d0 means this is the index value. So 0 in terms of binary means 0, 0. That will be given. Suppose d1 is activated. d1 means this index value is 1. So binary value of 1 is 0, 1. That will be get your output. And suppose if d2 is given, taken as, so d2 means 2 is index value. So you will get 1, 0 at your output. And when 3 is taken, so 3 is your index value here. So this will be taken at your output. So this is normal, like normal encoder. But this particular function will be always, this particular function will be always dependent, or it decides your functionality. This priority encoder always function with help of priority function only. It operates only on the priority function. Okay. Suppose if the value of v is 0, that means priority function is not assigned, then the circuit won't work. So it will use no output. It gives the respect output only when priority function is activated. Activated means the value of v should be always 1. V should be always 1. Now, see, when d0 is activated, the particular one sequence will, that means what is the binary value of 0? 0, 0. That will be verified at your, okay. When the first d0 is activated, the index value is 0, so that you will get 0, 0. The binary form of 0 is 0, 0. That will get your output. When the second input, what is that? D1. When D1 is activated, here the index value is 1. Therefore, the binary format of 1 is 0, 1. That will be obtained here. Suppose if third input D2, what is this D2? Second 2 is the index value. Sorry. Suppose if I highlighted this 1, which is nothing but D2, where 2 is the index value, the binary format of 2 is 1, 0. That will be activated. And the last case, fourth input D3, 3 is index value. So binary format of 3 is 1, 1. This will be apparent output. Then, see, when we are, what is these all values? These are all the values representing your don't care condition. That means these cells or these places can be either replaced with 0 or you can replace with 1. Irrespective of these values, these outputs will be generated. Why? Because we are given priority here. Okay. I will change the color. This green color line is the cells which are given priority. That's why these cells only considered for your outputs. Okay. And the preceding ones, that means these three are the preceding for D0. These two are preceding for D1. This cell is preceding for D2 and no preceding cell for T3. Okay, so these particular cells are taken as don't care, and these particular cells are taken as zero. Okay, carefully observe here. Only this particular line of these particular cells are given priority, and the preceding cells maybe don't care, but these cells should be zero. Why? Because we are moving towards this side, and priority is given 1, 1, 1 each and every step. Okay, at that particular moment, you will get the four combinations 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1 at your output. Now, as we are having three outputs, V is a priority function, Y naught is the first output, Y1 is second output, we should find the output expressions by using K-map. Okay, if you find these, you will get these equations. By using K-map, if you simplify them, you will get these expressions, and these will be written in a form of logic diagram. Total, I am having four inputs, right? So D0, D1, D2, D3. And when I observe the entire expressions, I am finding D2 bar also. That's why for only D2, I applied an inverter with a line called D2 bar. Okay, this is a line. Okay, this is a line representing D2 bar, D2 bar. Okay, now what is the equation of Y1? D2 plus D3. So draw an OR gate, supply D2, connect D2 and D3, make it as Y1. And what is Y0? D3 plus D1 D2 bar. So for this particular term, take one AND gate. What is that? D2 bar and D1. And that is to be added with D3. So take an OR gate and supply with this R3. Therefore, it is an Y. And what is the equation of V? Adding of all D1, D2, D3, D4. So take an OR gate and collect all this and supply to this, so that we will get the logic diagram. Okay, this very, very important. Okay, this priority encoder is very, very important. Okay. See here, this priority encoder important. I will explain here. Listen once again. This priority encoder is encoder that includes the priority function. That means until unless this V value is 1, the circuit won't generate the output. That is the condition. If V is equal to 0 means priority function is not assigned. Not assigned means you won't get any output. See carefully. If V is equal to 0 in the sense, the priority function is not assigned. It means that you won't get any output. When you will get output? When the value of V is equal to 1 only. Okay. So when you will get the value of 1 here, so see that. Suppose the first D0 is taken as, or it is given as priority. So what is the index here? D0, it is the first output, 0th output input. So you will get 0, 0. The binary form of 0 is 0, 0. Suppose if you take second input D1 as your priority, and 1 here, 1 is the index value. So binary form of 1 is 0, 1. So you will get here. Suppose if you take D2 as the priority, so D2 means 2 is the index value. So conversion of 2 into binary is 1, 0, 1. So you will get 0, 1 here for 1, 0 here. And D3 means this one, and this one is nothing but related to third one. So you will get 1, 1 at your output. So remember that wherever you find 1, that 1 is the priority cell, and that input is converted into binary form. And the preceding cells are taken as don't care, and the followed cells are taken with 0. Okay, clear? So this truth table is very, very important. Please practice this truth table. Okay, and remember, wherever you are writing 1, that particular output should resemble the binary format of the index number. Suppose if you write 1 here, this index number is 2, therefore the output should represent the binary format of 2. What is binary format of 2? 1, 0. Suppose if you take this one is related to D1, where 1 is the index value. What is the binary format of 1? 0, 1. So 0, 1 should be written in the output. Suppose if you take this one as a priority, this is related to D3. 3 is the index value. So 3 in terms of binary is 1, 1. So take here 1, 1. Okay, like that you should frame the sequence. And remember that the preceding cells of your priority function, suppose if this is the priority function, this is the preceding one, this is forward one. Okay, these preceding cells should be taken as don't care in 2 marks, and the remaining followed cells to be taken as 0. Okay, you can see these cells are taken as don't care, and these cells should be taken as 0. Okay, and these particular cells will be 1. Okay, this is the sequence which is given for priority, and these followed cells are taken 0 and the preceding cells are taken don't care. Then you will get these respective sequences, which are the binary format of these index numbers, binary formats of these index numbers. Okay, clear? So by this the concept of encoder is completed as per your syllabus. Okay, please learn the previous one, that is octal to binary encoder, this priority encoder, that too, this truth table is very, very important. And by using this truth table, we can convert this truth table into K-map simplification. And you simplify this, you will get these expressions and draw the same expressions in terms of this logic diagram. Okay. So in the next session, we will meet with a new topic, always multiplexer. Okay, if you have any doubts, you can ask me or you can post in the comment section. Thank you and have a nice day.